us and lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Please turn and face the flag. Place your right hand over your heart. Ready? Begin. Thank you. Please be seated. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce the director of this prestigious academy, our director, Mr. Vincent Rivarol.
Thank you, Susan. Please be seated. Good evening, seniors, parents, GPA board members, staff, and community. Welcome to our senior convocation. Tonight is the night that we praise and honor and bless our seventh senior class. This is the time to come together as a family and give our love, support, and continued encouragement as you begin your senior year, the class of 2019. Now, for the past 11 years, you have worked hard to get to this point. As you think about this upcoming senior year, I know you have fears about what the future may hold for you. Trust me, each class before you has felt the same way as they sat in your seats. Some of you may be nervous about all the things that you have to do to graduate, the pressures of choosing a college and starting a new life, and the thought of moving on. Thinking about all these things and any personal challenges you may face can feel overwhelming. So, let's play a game. Try to guess, without saying anything out loud, the answer to the following riddle. What one thing can be a pirate's treasure and an ingredient in microcircuits, has been used to make jewelry since 4000 BC, and used to treat cancer in recent decades, is in the pot at the end of the rainbow and the coating on astronauts' visors, and is something I see as I look out at each and every one of you. You see, gold is a precious metal, which means it's rare, it's valuable, and it's worth investing in. You, class of 2019, are gold. Now, I know this, your family knows this, the GPA staff knows this, but do you know this? Do you know this about yourselves? Are you ready to discover what makes you gold? Because I've done a lot of thinking about the class of 2019, so I'm going to tell you what makes you gold. So let's do a little digging. Get it? Gold digging. Thank you, front row. On the surface, we knew that gold is shiny and attractive on the surface. And as I look out at all of you, the class of 2019, you have that part down. Don't they look good, parents? Clean shaven. Nice job, gentlemen. You really do look amazing. As we dig a little deeper, there is more to gold than just the alluring appearance. It is the properties within that make it extraordinary. We've all heard of fool's gold, the kind that looks like gold on the surface, but doesn't have what it takes on the inside to be true gold. Same is true for all of us. No matter how much we do to our outer appearance, it's what's inside that matters most. And that makes the most important impact on all our lives. So I thought a lot about you as a class, and I believe there are 5 keys to help you find what makes you gold. Before you can begin, your mindset must be in the right place. Take a moment right now to get right with yourself. Take a clean, cleansing, deep breath. Be in the moment. This is your moment to get right with yourselves. Let your guard down. Relax. You are sitting in a treasure box, not a box. Let me repeat that. In a treasure box, not a battle zone. Every successful gold miner knows that step one is believing that there is actually gold to be found. There is gold in you. That's the first key. Believe you are gold. Once that mindset is clear, miners then rely on their best tool, themselves. An expert miner here in our Golden State, Dave McCracken, said, quote, "You are the one who makes decisions for yourself. You decided to get into mining in the first place. You also make the decision on how you're going to approach gold mining, how you're going to deal with all the problems and barriers to your success. Regardless of suggestions or input you receive from others, you make the final decision on what you're going to do, no matter what they are." End quote. Same is true when deciding when you are made of, what gold is in you that you want to discover. I need to share this quote with you and ask that you own it. Anyone can find the dirt in someone. Be the one that finds the gold in someone. That leads me to second key. Discover your gold. One of the reasons gold is so unique and worth digging is its malleability. To be malleable is defined by Webster as having the capacity for adaptive change. This means be flexible and be able to become something new your senior year, to adapt to the situation in order to succeed. Digging for gold in yourself means being open to the shifts life brings, and it will bring many your senior year. Be ready to change, and knowing that you can adapt to what is in front of you and still be the most valuable part of the puzzle. You will need to let go of old habits. Let it go. The old way of thinking. You have never been here before, in this seat, with that tie. This is a new step for all of you. Do not bring the past with you. I know there have been some times that you, as a class, have had to adapt junior village, to be flexible, junior village, and to adjust, junior village. I thank you for that, and I thank you for your spirit in that adaptation. That was your chance to be gold. Think about that. In fact, many of you took that opportunity to go for the gold by doubling our pass rate in AP English language. You more than doubled our pass rate in AP US history. And one of you is the first to pass AP Spanish as a non-Spanish native speaker. Now, five of the seniors passed Calculus AB. And even more impressive, two of you are the first to pass Calculus BC without even taking the class here at Gompers Prep. Yay! Now, if that didn't knock your socks off, we also have a member of your class who is the first student to pass 4 out of the 5 AP exams in 1 year. Again, gold. Parents, that actually puts a little gold back in your pocket. You get it? You just saved a lot of money. So, it is a choice you make every day. Keep growing, keep dreaming, and decide to make this year better than your wildest imaginings. And that's the third key. Choose gold. Another attribute that makes gold such a highly sought-out precious metal is the fact that it's a very good conductor of electricity. As you search for what makes you gold, think about what you spend your energy on. Here we go. Are you using your gold to generate positive electricity? You get it. AP. Now, we all have power. And with that power, we make decisions every day. How are you spending your energy? Are you using your power to improve your life and the lives of those who love you, who champion you, who believe in you? The energy you put into two things is the energy you will get back. If you spend all your time sending negative messages to yourself and others, I guarantee you negativity is going to come back to you. If you spend all your time sending positive messages to yourself and others, I guarantee you positivity will come to you. And that is the fourth key. Nurture your gold. Now that the last key is the trickiest, because perhaps it's the most important. We all know that having gold can make a person greedy. Kingdoms have fallen and wars have started due to this greed. People can become obsessed with getting gold. But gold is not meant to be hoarded, especially the gold we have in each of us. In fact, the more we hold on to our gold and keep it from shining, the more our gold becomes coal. The irony is, you can only be generous with your gold if you love yourself first. You may have heard the phrase, be as good as gold. This means to be authentic, to be yourself, to be the real deal, to be legit. In order to be the true you, you must like who that is. This is the challenge we all face. Do we like ourselves? Think about it. Our school song, you know, the one, the greatest love of all. It's all about learning to love yourself. The best way to love who we are is by giving to others and sharing our hearts. So, I challenge you to make this year a year that you give of yourself, that you share your gratitude, that you open your hearts to the opportunities in front of you, to the people in front of you, to the path we've laid out for you since you stepped foot on this campus 7 years ago. To find gold, you have to give your gold. And that means having the courage to give people your best. Be gold. Hand in gold work. Communicate with gold manners. Learn with gold minds. Give back with gold hearts. And here is the fifth and final key. Give your gold. This is a big day. This is an exciting year. You've made it all the way to this moment. And you have the power to make this night and every other moment in your life exceptional. There will be challenges, seniors. It will take hard work. But I know, we know, you can do this. You are precious, you are valuable, and you are worth investing in. We believe in you. It is your turn to believe in yourself. Because the class of 2019, you are gold. Thank you. Thank you, seniors. Thank you. Please be seated. At this time, I'd like to invite to the podium Senior Seth C., who will lead the class of 2019 in their senior pledge.
Thank you, Director, for your encouraging words. Class of 2019, we are golden. We are rare. We are worth investing in. There are many people here tonight who have invested in us, who helped us discover our gold. We are lucky to attend a school that delivers on its promises, that puts students first, that treats us like the precious metals we are. We are blessed to have people that look out for us, that trust us, that bring out the best in us. Our families, our teachers, and our community have all played a role in bringing us to this day. It took a lot of hard work on our part and on theirs. Let's call them what they are, family. Our families are gold. Our parents and guardians have sacrificed so much for us to be here. From waking us up in the morning to reminding us to complete our homework each night. They are the golden rays of love and support and kindness and affection. Sometimes they tell us what we want to hear, and other times they tell us what we need to hear. Our family started us on our journey, have stayed by our side, and will always be there for us. Our teachers are gold. Every teacher, especially the ones that pushed us, challenged us, made us grow, even when we didn't want to. Their gold is the valuable treasure of knowledge, a gift they have given us for free. They trust us with their golden nuggets of wisdom because they see the potential in all of us. The potential to be leaders. The potential to do the right thing. The potential to change the world. Our community is gold. This neighborhood in Southeast San Diego is a golden light of hope. The people who live here believe in a better life, and that makes our community a true community. We are not in competition with each other. Instead, we recognize that we are golden because we work together. And that makes us strong. And that makes us rare. Class of 2019, we are rare. We are special. We are worth investing in. Our commitment to every single person here is that this is just the beginning of our process to a better life. We won't make you proud because we are the dream. Seniors, please stand and repeat after me. We are a family.
We are a family.
No one will be left behind.
No one will be left behind.
We are the class of 2019.
We are the class of 2019.
Thank you.
Running for governor. Let's give Seth another round of applause. Future governor of the great state of California. At this time, we will officially induct each of our future graduates into their senior year at Gompers Preparatory Academy by placing their senior blazers on them. And now the teachers, our senior teachers, will officially assist me with the inducting of the senior class.
Thank you.
Let's give the class of 2019 another round of applause. Seniors, now that you're officially inducted, your first opportunity to give your gold and take responsibility in your new role as the class of 2019 is to recognize and share gratitude to our GPA Board of Directors. And there are three of them here today. We're going to honor them for their service to our college prep school. Please notice, seniors, that I waited until you were all officially inducted into your senior year to provide you with this golden opportunity. Traditions matter. Gold counts. So seniors, at this time, please stand and remain standing to acknowledge our esteemed GPA board members with a round of applause coming on stage. GPA is extremely fortunate to have board members that go above and beyond to support our students and staff. Their work never ends, as they are the voices out in the community day and night that continue to talk us up, share stories, and support our vision, our mission, and all that we do here at GPA. I'm going to present to them a gold pen. And this pen is a symbol of the heartfelt gratitude from all students, families, and staff for all that you do. Thank you. I just want you to know this is what gratitude feels like. Gratitude comes from the deep part of your body, from your soul. When you have real gratitude, it looks like this, feels like this. I just want to take a special moment to honor the chairman of the board, Dr. Cecil H. Stepp. He is an inspiration and a role model in every way, and my professional mentor. To show our utmost love and appreciation, sir, the senior class of 2019 has donated a new bench in your honor to be placed under your favorite shade tree on this occasion. And the bench reads, Dr. Cecil H. Stepp, founding chairman of the board, Gompers Preparatory Academy. quote, "We must remember that intelligence isn't enough. Intelligence plus character, that is the goal of a true education." Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. dedicated the summer of 2018. I officially dedicate this as the Cecil H. Step Bench. Let's give our board members a round of applause. Thank you, seniors. Please be seated. Look at the sunset. Isn't it beautiful? It's golden. I ordered that shade for you tonight. And now, a tribute to you. Class of 2019, singing Fields of Gold, ladies and gentlemen, Destiny Harper.
Congratulations, seniors. You are gold.
Another round of applause for Destiny Parker. Thank you, Destiny. At this time, I'm going to ask for our newest seniors, the class of 2019, to begin the recessional and then meet your parents over a reception area for some cake and fellowship. Thank you and good evening.